Hi everyone, I'm Faisal Abid, I'm an Android architect at League, and I'm here to talk to you about Android data binding. Now currently when you're building your list view or recycler view adapters, what you have to do is first download the object, you're probably using something like retrofit, convert that JSON into your plain old Java object, and then get that POJO converted into your layout file. What that usually means is tons and tons of findViewbyid calls all over the place. Then you have to make sure, you know, if you're showing the right views by messing around visibility, that ends up taking a lot of your time, a lot of bloated code. Now, what if there was a solution? A few months ago, Google I/O, Google announced an open source project called Android Data Binding. The brilliantness of the solution is that Android Data Binding doesn't need to run at runtime. It runs at compile time. As long as you're using Android Studio, all you're doing is adding a few great plugins in and letting Android Studio, the compiler, deal with all the compilation and generating your adapter for you. What that means for you is less code, and you're really writing all your code in your layout files. It's really like data binding. It is a great, great solution. And now, why don't we go take a look at my laptop and see how we can actually integrate data binding into your project. First, let's take a look at the sample app we'll be building. It's a very simple app, and all it's going to show is hello world and an integer. Sounds really trivial, but if you were to do this in normal Android development, you would have to create a layout file, create an adapter, find view by ID twice, make sure it's being recycled properly, and once all that's done, just make sure there's no memory leaks. Android data binding makes it very simple. The first thing you have to do is make sure that in your build.gradle file for the entire project, you've included the following two lines. This upgrades your Gradle to 1.3.0 beta, and also adds the data binder plugin. The next thing you want to do is go to the build.gradle for your application and add the plugin for com.android.databinding. Don't worry if you're not getting this via the screen. There's notes at the bottom on how to do this from their website. For the sake of this, I used a recycler view, so I added a recycler view plugin to my build.gradle. And if you're not using recycler view, it's a very lightweight list view that has a lot of optimizations. The next thing you want to do is build your model file. Here we have a simple object model file, and we have two properties here. We have name and int, which is an age. For the sake of the demo, I've left name as a public string and age as a private string with getter and setter variables. What this allows us to do is, in your layout file, instead of writing the text as an integer, we actually convert the age into a string. You'll see what I mean in a second. Next, you want to create an actual layout file that holds this object. Now, this is the magic of Android data binding. I've created a layout file here called Adapter Simple Project. Looks like any other layout file. If we go to design, it looks just like a layout file with nothing here. On the right-hand side, you can see the two text views that I have. You'll notice that I don't even have an ID on the text view. I don't need it. What number one thing you have to do for Android data binding is wrap the whole thing in a layout class. This layout class is available when you apply the Android data binding plugin. The next thing you have to do is tell data binding what your class is that you're using. You'll notice here that I have a variable called simple object, and it's pointing to the simple object class we previously created. Now the rest of the layout is just like any other Android layout. I have a linear layout and two text views. The interesting thing here is if you look at the text value for both text views, you'll see that they reference simpleObject.name and simpleObject.age. Now you'll notice this is why we added a getter and setter to our age variable, because if we were to just assign the number one, an integer one, it would actually try to find the layout or the string value that references the integer one rather than the string one. We've also added some text styling here, like you saw previously, blue color for the name and red color for the age. Once we have that, it's time to create our adapter. Now this adapter is a bit special. We're not doing a lot of findViewbyIDs or any manipulation of the views. We just have a simple recyclerview adapter that extends simple object holder. We'll look into that in a second. When we create the view holder, we create a class that is dynamically generated. You'll notice we never actually created this class, Adapter Simple Project Binding, but depending on the name of your layout file, adapter, simple project, it automatically generates it. So you create this file, you assign a data binding util as a static class, you inflate your layout that references this file, and you pass it to your simple object holder, which we'll look into right now. We pass in the binding object as the holder, and in a method that we created ourselves called bind object, we pass in the simple object and we tell binding, take my simple object model and bind it to the layout. Binding.setSimpleObject. Again, this is all dynamically generated via the adapter simple project binding. Lastly, just like any other recycler view holder, we have a method we need to override on bind view holder. It passes in the holder value and the position. We take the holder and we bind connection and we pass in the model. And if we go into bind connection, it's what we just saw, binding.setSimpleObject. Once that's done, that's it. You've created your adapter. No need to do findviewbyids, no need to manipulate a lot of data. Everything is there, works out of the box. And if you're wondering how you actually assign your adapter to recyclerview, it's just like any other Android project you've done. You get an instance to your recyclerview, you create your model objects. Here I just have a for loop that runs 100 times and assigns hello world and age, as you saw in the previous video. Then we just instantiate our adapter like normal, regular Android development. For recyclerview, we set a linear layout manager, again, just like regular Android development. And finally, we set the adapter. There's nothing new here. This should all be familiar. The only thing new is the layout file that we add the new data binding calls to. And there you have it. As you saw, Android data binding is really powerful. It speeds up a lot of development tasks that you're stuck doing if you just want to instantiate a list view and show some data. And thank you for watching the video. If there's anything else you would like to learn about, feel free to reach out to me on Twitter at Faisal Abid. It'll be down there in the show notes below. And I hope Android data binding makes your life easier. Thank you.
So let's open the app. There is a new notification I received. So it says Android Wear, press. So that's a notification on the phone. And on the watch, we'll see. That's the same notification.